know there's a lot of other things I don't want to do. About 7
This is November the 16th, and we are here for our meeting with the Board of Directors for November. It's 6:30, and we're at the clubhouse at 4801 Lakeside Plus Boulevard. Before I start the meeting officially, I would like to thank Ed, Pat, Ricky for hosting the flag raising and luncheon on Veterans Day. Ed especially did a great job emceeing both programs. At this time, would our best please stand so we may recognize his service. Thank you. Second, I'd like to honor our veterans who have passed away during this past year. As you know, the last was, but first on my list is Don Clearman, Ben Izzo, Jolyn Mendo, Ben LaSala, George Schnipp, and John Szymanski. Please take a moment. Take a moment of silence to remember these fallen heroes. Thank you. In addition, we would like to honor Kathy Fox's father, Vernon, who passed away last Saturday. The notice will be put on the board if you want to send some cards. We now rise for the pledge of allegiance.
One nation,
under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Yes, if you call the roll, please.
Yes. Tom McIntyre.
Here.
Skip Zimmerman.
Here.
Scott Harris.
Here.
Jennifer Rando.
Here.
Kathy Levin.
Here.
Ken Jerome. Mike
Rolanda. Thank you, Kathy. Was this properly noticed?
Yes, it was.
Okay, we now have a few minutes for the open forum. I think I should explain how this works for some of the people that are new. We have an open forum that allows you to address any problem or any subject you want to address before the meeting is actually in session. But you still have to have permission to speak. And you're allowed 4 minutes to state your cause. And then at the end, we've decided to put in a question and answer period that may clear up problems that arise during the meeting. Okay, the first on the list to for intent to speak is Carl Pyatt.
Okay, honestly, look, that this should be on the agenda tonight, but I guess it's not. I don't think it's working. We used to have a podium. They've done everything. A podium, you know, where people could stand up. Anyway, what I want to talk about tonight is I want to talk about the new rules and regulations that's coming up. I thought it would be on a meeting on the agenda tonight, and it's not, and I'm not going to be here for the next meeting. I'm going to work for the holidays. So I want to discuss it. I don't expect any answers, for getting any confrontations over this thing, but I'm a little upset by it. And it has to do with the carts, dump carts, of which we probably are getting more and more, and we have maybe, I don't know, I think 5, 6 besides the maintenance guys. So we have a few dump carts here. I'd like to address it like number one, number two, number three, number four. Now, number one, it says carts must have headlights and taillights. Well, we know that, okay? But at night, if you're going to be out there at night, you should already have the intelligence to have taillights and headlights. But I think that also pedestrians walking should have flashlights and reflective clothing. And that's not mentioned. The only thing that's mentioned is
I mentioned that last week.
What?
When? During the meeting. It's in our minutes.
Oh, okay. I was I here? I don't know because I didn't remember the meeting last week. But anyway, I think that's a good idea. But nothing was mentioned about that. It was on the golf course. Okay, now number two was you must have a driver's license. Well, that should really be the choice of the individual person because driver's licenses are not required to by the state of Florida to operate a golf cart, okay? And I think we go by rules and regulations that are afforded to us by the state of Florida, okay? So number three, that was one of the big issues I had. Carts must obey laws But again, it fails to mention anything with golf carts about traffic laws and being safe. The one I want to address is the number four. Carts are not allowed to be driven on a path in front of north and west condos. 5 golf carts. Other people here have golf carts. And I've lived here since 1994. I've been a permanent resident, in which I served on the board, president, vice president, for 8 years. Maybe more than that point. I think I served for another year with Glen Apple. That would be even older position on the board. Well, what I'm getting at is, during that time, I've never seen damaging property or hurting people in Pine Ridge golf carts. Never seen that. Of course, we didn't have that many then. Unlike cars that take down mailboxes, run into front gates, drove their cars into lanais, okay, and maybe a couple dozen squirrels are killed every year because people drive too fast in the street out here. And that's another issue. But it's the truth. People just drive too damn fast. Okay, but I don't see that mentioned in here. It's not. There's nothing mentioned about anything like bicycles having accidents. There's been a few accidents with bicycles. Maybe some of you don't remember, but I remember them. Okay, from the time I was on board.
We have one more minute.
Okay. I guess I'm kind of getting my point across. My point across is that you got bicycles, you got scooters, you got segways, you got skateboards, you have all kinds of transportation here that people use. None of that's mentioned on the golf carts. So it leads me to believe that somebody has something against golf carts. Now, I don't know who that is. I think that the board should, the majority of the board should not vote in favor of this law because I think it's discriminating. It actually comes under collective punishment, which is a military-style law. And the definition of collective punishment is a penalty imposed upon every member of the group without regard to his or her involvement in the group's action and conduct. And that could mean not only golf carts, but it means in a pool.
I'm sorry, Carl, your time is up. we'll take a vote to see if you should continue. Does anyone wish for him to continue on this board?
I do. Yes, I'd like for him to continue.
Okay, continue.
All right, thank you very much, I appreciate that. I'm almost done. It's very hard to stand up here like this without a podium, you know? And I know some people that never do it. I do a little bit once in a while, but it's pretty hard. Individual causes, if any individual in this community causes danger or harm to anyone, violating common safety rules that are in effect in Pine Ridge, each individual that does this should be dealt with, okay, accordingly, according to the process that we already have in place here. We have a process here. If I get in trouble, you can bring me up on a board. And you can find, you can't collect, but you can find them. Okay? That's another law that's kind of enforceable. But anyway, I like you to hear what I'm saying. I think that if this passes, it's directed at me. And I've never been discourteous to anybody out here. I don't see anybody with a golf cart that has been discourteous to anybody. So I can't see any reason why this thing should have brought about. I'd really like to know who brought this to the board. And I'd like to know if there's people complaining. Let them come down here and stand up and complain about it. Get it off their chest. Okay, that's it.
Thank you.
That's all I want to say. All right? Thank you.
Mike Hartman.
Do I have to use a microphone?
I do have to use a microphone. I only have a minor concern. It has to do with the temperature.
Can't hear you.
Can't hear you.
Can I talk this way? I have a minor concern with the temperature in the jacuzzi. It's just a little bit cool. My wife and I have been gone a couple of weeks. We got back tonight. I'm ready to go in. I haven't yet, but she tells me it's still pretty cool. And I understand there's probably a maximum temperature that you can only allow for a jacuzzi. I don't know if it's 104 degrees or what it is, but I'm just asking if maybe we could consider raising the temperature for the jacuzzi, especially since the nights are getting a little cooler now and for our own enjoyment. I don't think it's again, I don't know how often it's monitored and that sort of thing. So thank you.
Thank you, Mike.
Well, we'll check the heater and make sure that it is working. I think you can only keep it at a maximum of 104. Try to keep it at 102, 103 range just in case. Yeah, could be a problem with the heater, so we can double check that and make sure. It is cooler outside, so that take that into account too.
Bill and Kathy England.
I would like to address the golf cart rule also. First of all, I'd like to thank y'all for the new gate system we have in. To me, it's working good because you don't see the tailgaters coming in behind you or somebody might get the gate to get in. So I like that part. I'd just like to give you a few stats, first of all, on the ones that don't know a whole lot about golf carts. The width of a golf cart is anywhere from 48 to 51 inches wide. They can weigh anywhere from 495 pounds to 798 pounds, 50. So you put two people in a 500 pound cart, conservatively, you're looking at 1,100 to 1,200 pounds. You put four people in that cart, you're looking at 1,500 to 1,600 pounds. Now, how do you stop that cart 1,600 pounds of weight? A golf cart is only designed, when you're initially designed for two people. You can add the rack in the back to haul some more, but they're only designed for two golfers. That's what they were made for. I could ride around. But anyway, our walkways out here we have now aren't designed to withstand 1,000 to 1,500 pounds of weight traveling back and forth. They're already cracked, they've got sags and spots. We've had to go over and do patching. And it's just gonna get worse to go out of those carts running around on the walking path. To me, it's a walking path. I don't know what to call it. There's bicycles on there, and that's fine. I'm gonna talk to the bicycles. Or the guys that have to ride the mobility scooter. have no problem with those either. Safe in. We got it up also. With these walkways that we have out here, is anywhere from 60 to 72 inches wide. Someone with a walker or a mobility scooter that needs a cart, who gets out of the way, and what do? There's no turnoff, so they got to, somebody's got to get in the grass. That brings up another problem. Who pays for the damage to the grass? And there's drop-offs on each side of the sidewalks out here, anywhere from 2 inches to 6 inches in depth, from the edge of the sidewalk. You run a cart or a walker or a mobility scooter off the edge of that, and it turns over, then what have you got? Someone hurt, someone could get killed, someone going to the lake and drown. Is that what we want?
I'm sorry, your time's almost up. One more minute.
It comes down to who pays for this. Someone gets hurt, someone gets killed, who's going to pay for it? We have to repave all the walkways, who pays for that? I don't think it should be me having to pay for it. I don't have it, right? I got a bicycle, but I don't think I should have to pay for it. They don't have any fishing allowed in front of all these condos out here, so why should you allow a golf cart drive around when you can't fish it? You know, you got a guy wanting to fish, okay, you won't let him. What's the danger of him there versus a 1,200-pound golf cart driving around? And next, the only thing I have right with that is, where do you get on the road to pass that walkway? Well, we got one means of egress, and it's out here at the end of the building. Go around the other way, there's no way else to get out. You gotta go on the sidewalk somewhere. Then how's the people gonna walk? They ain't got nowhere to walk. Somebody's in the grass is pulling up. And we're trying to make this place look good. And you keep tearing everything up, it's not gonna look good for long. And we bought our condo on the lakeside because we wanted a piece of quiet. And I'd like to keep that. If you want to call me selfish, you can call me that. But I want to keep it simple.
Okay, thank you, Bill. So. One of the Rickies want to say something?
Yeah.
On both?
She's always got something to say.
No supper for you, Bill.
I just wanted to thank everyone for getting up early on Veterans Day and participating in the flag ceremony we had outside. It was very moving, and it was nice to remember the veterans that passed away this year. And I want to make a special shout out to Larry DeLong, who supplied the music for Taps and the Star Spangled Banner outside. And then when we had our luncheon in here, he put the slideshow together with all the pictures of the veterans that everybody was browsing through while we were eating. I just want to make mention of the fact, anybody that was in the military, husband, wife, if you have a picture of yourself in uniform, kindly bring it down, give it to Eric in the office. He'll put it on our website. And then it'll be transferred over to Larry DeLong, who will put it on the screen for when we have our slideshow presentations. But please, if you have a picture of yourself, bring it down to Eric. But finally, I want to give a special shout out to Lars, who took care of the flag raising ceremony on Veterans Day. It was very moving. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Can't read the writing. The signature. Don. Apple. I do know you.
I don't know anything about golf carts, but we could go today. My father-in-law was killed in an accident. My mother-in-law was injured. She has a brain concussion. And he died on Friday early. I just want to take a minute to thank Pine Ridge for the carts, for the food, for the love, and for all those who attended the memorial service. It was a blessing. Every time you think this place is a place where all they do is fight and argue, they show up big time when the going gets tough. And I just surely want to thank everybody, and thank you from the family. And right now, Beulah needs a little rest, so I know some people mean well, but right now, she doesn't need any phone calls or visits. So God bless you all, and God bless Pine Ridge.
Thank you, Donnie. Sir, previous meeting minutes.
The minutes have been compiled and posted on the website and are available here in the office.
Can I make a motion to waive the reading of the minutes?
What?
Can I make a motion to waive the reading of the minutes?
I'll
second
that.
Since they've been posted.
I didn't hear. I couldn't understand what you said.
Yeah, motion been made that we waive the reading of the minutes. For October, it's been motion been made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, they will be posted as said. Manager's report.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, everyone. Is that better?
Yes.
I want to begin tonight by talking about the annual meeting mailing that you either picked up on the way in, or if you did not, I encourage you to pick it up on the way out. Everyone that gets picked up saves us a couple dollars in postage and adds up. We worked all day long. There's a lot of information in that packet. I want to thank Edith James and Pat McClune, who work all day with Pamela and I to put these packets together. A lot of work to do this. The remaining packages that haven't been picked up will be mailed out tomorrow. You need to review the contents of the package very carefully. This packet includes your ballot for the election of the board of directors. It also includes your proxy which is very important that everybody fill out concerning the proxy. There's a couple questions on the proxy to vote. One of them is to opt out of retrofitting the buildings for fire sprinklers. That's a very expensive process, and when you retrofit, there are other problems with exposed piping and things like that that you'll see. And we have a certain deadline to opt out by, so I encourage you can vote however you want, but it's probably a good idea to opt out of that. The other is an amendment to our bylaws and our declaration of condominium. This would open it up to where, if the board decides to allow renters to have pets with the owner's permission, to have a pet with the owner's permission. That's a divisive question. I know some people vote yes, some people vote no. And there are pluses and minuses to both sides of it. So consider that as an important one to vote. The other question that's included in that exhibit is a provision that basically allows the board to, every year when we have a couple of amendments, it kind of makes the condo documents a mess. So every few years, I like to go back in and record a clean copy, compile it all together, and have one clean copy. And by voting yes to that, it will allow the board the flexibility to do that when they need to. When it becomes too much of a hodgepodge, go ahead and record brand new, clean copy, fix typos, things like that. Another question you'll see on there is waiving the financial audit. We are required to have an audit every year unless the members vote to waive that audit, in which case you can waive it for up to 3 years, and then in year four you have to have an audit performed. The audit can cost in the range of $10,000, and we had one done just a couple of years ago. The bottom line with a financial audit is we're still responsible for our numbers. They're just checking that proper accounting practices are being done, and we stay pretty well on top of that. We've got a very active budget committee. So that's up to you if you want to vote to waive or not the audit, but it does save us some money if we waive it. If you have any questions about the proxy, some of the language can be confusing, please see me or one of the board members can help you, and we'll explain it to you the best we can. But it's very important. We need to get at least 50% plus one of the proxies back in time for the annual meeting in order to have an annual meeting, in order to have a quorum. The meetings that we have here, like tonight, is a meeting of the board of directors. You guys are observing. The annual meeting is the only meeting of the year of the members. And that's your meeting. That's where the election takes place. And it's really important. So whether you plan on coming to the meeting or not, please fill out, sign, and return the proxy. And then with your election ballot, make sure you follow the instructions on the ballot exactly. We're going to have three separate envelopes. It all has to be done properly and sealed and signed properly, or else we can't count your vote. We have to invalidate it. And we want every vote to be valid, of course. So if you have questions, come and see me. I'm more than happy to help you. This year for the board is kind of exciting. We have six candidates. We have the four incumbents, which are Scott Harris, Ken Jerome, Mike Lallon, and Tommy McIntyre. And we have two new candidates, Bill England and John Fricker. Tuesday, November 22nd, next Tuesday here in the clubhouse, we are going to have a Meet the Candidates event. The candidates will have the chance to introduce themselves, give a little bit of background of what they bring to the table as potential board members, and then we'll also open it up to the audience. You'll have an opportunity to ask the candidates a question that you may have for them. So it's an important thing. We encourage everyone to attend. For those who aren't going to be here, can't make it, we're going to video record the Meet the Candidates, and we will post a video of it on YouTube the day or two following the event, and you'll be able to log on to our website, click a link, and view that anytime you want to. So if you're not here, don't worry, you'll still get to see it here. Staying on the topic of the election, we have the most important part of the election is counting the votes, and we need to put together an election committee to get together and make sure the votes are counted in an open and transparent way to make sure there's no funny business. The committee that we need, the method that we have for counting, it takes a fair amount of people. We need somewhere between 12 and 15 volunteers in order to do this. And we're going to have one, if possibly two meetings to review it. We'll do like a test election and candidate A, B, and C, and just that way we can run through it. If you're interested in volunteering, and we encourage, if you volunteer and helped with an election in the past, we encourage you to volunteer again because you're already familiar with the process. But we're going to put a sign-up sheet on the board. We need about 14 or 15 volunteers. The only restriction on who can volunteer is you cannot be a candidate or a candidate's spouse, and you cannot be a board member or a board member's spouse. So if you don't fall into one of those categories and you're interested in volunteering, please sign up and do that. Also in your package, as was talked about in the open forum, you're going to get updated rules and regulations for the community. The rules and regulations, what we need to do, what's required by the state, is we send out, you copy of the revised rules along with a notice for a meeting where the rules will be discussed, and we have to give you at least 14 days notice. That's why the rules are not on the agenda today. So everybody who got their package, and as you get them in the mail, review those, and there will be a special board meeting on December 7th at 6:30, that's a Wednesday here, to review and potentially adopt these revised rules. So if you're interested in them, you'll have a copy in your election or annual meeting packet. Moving on, I just wanted to give a couple quick updates of things going on in the community. Decorating for Christmas, we will be next week decorating the front entrance for Christmas and getting it all ready. I know everybody likes to see that, and we'll do a good job on that. Annual flowers, we'll be pulling out the yellow Alamanda from the center island, those yellow flowers that you see, and we'll be putting in red and pink begonias. What happens when it starts to cool down, those yellow flowers go away and kind of have like an uglier looking plant. So we'll go ahead and yank those out, and we'll put in something that will bloom all winter long. Mulch, we're going to, shortly after Thanksgiving, we're going to begin mulching the community as we do every year. This year, something a little different. We're going to go with a cocoa brown, a dark brown mulch, rather than the red mulch, which is what we've used traditionally. You should freshen it up, give it a little different look, a little more natural. And I think everybody will like it. It's the direction that a lot of the big communities are going. They're going away from the red into the dark brown. Currently, we're waiting for the county to approve the installation of the electricity for the new shop. Once, we hope to have that by the end of the week, or maybe next week they can come and do it. Once that's done, we can move the guys in there officially. They're already halfway in now. And begin to wrap up that project, the shop. The new gate system is up and running. I was happy to hear that we didn't have any complaints about it at the open forum. That's a good sign. Overall, it went pretty well. I was watching it pretty closely last night on the surveillance cameras to make sure there was no major incidents. Looked like there were one or two backups, but I think that's to be expected with a brand new system. So I hope it's working for everybody. If you are experiencing difficulty or a problem, come and see me, and we will try to come up with a solution for you. The last thing I have is we have a community power washing project that continues. We're trying to hit the worst areas first, the dirtiest areas first. But if you have somewhere that you think should be power washed or we should look at, please come fill out a work order and we will look at it. And if it's appropriate, we'll put it on the list because we expect this to be an ongoing project. Lastly, I just want to wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving next week and safe travels if you're traveling. Thank you.
Thank you. Now I have the treasurer's report.
I'm happy to report again that the treasury remains stable. Tonight the board will vote to adopt the proposed 2017 operating and reserve budget. The 2017 budget does call for each unit to have a small increase of approximately 2% or between $15 and $21 each quarter, more than you paid in 2016. However, every unit owner will still be paying less in 2017 than they did in 2015. The operating side of the budget, which is what is used to run the day-to-day options of the association, is less for 2017 than we had budgeted in 2016. This number we have some control over by deciding which projects, repairs, or maintenance items to tackle in a given year. Where we are seeing the increase in dues is the reserve budget. We do not have the same control over these items because the unit pricing for the large construction items such as painting, paving, and roofing is largely tied to the economy. Since the economy is doing better and the building industry is experiencing a boom, the cost of these large items has gone up. Our accounting firm is running a little behind this month due to the upcoming holiday, so I do not have the balance sheet and income statement for October yet. As soon as we receive it from the accounting firm, we will make it available. If you have more questions about the treasury or the specifics of the budget, please let us know, and Eric and I will be more than happy to sit down with you and go over any details. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, on the president's report, I have, I'd also like to recap some of the things we've accomplished over the last year or so. And a lot of this is going to be repeat from the other people, I'm afraid. So we have a new entry system that hopefully will make us safer over the next few years. Each car that enters the property will be videotaped to show who is driving as well as their license plate. This will help keep out strangers who tailgate behind the residence but have no business in Pine Ridge. You may have noticed that the gate bar does not go down if it reads the RFID transponder in the car behind you. However, if no responder is in the car behind you, the gate will come down. And so proceed with caution. In case yours doesn't work, don't break the gate. They're expensive. And we have your license number. As you know, we've constructed a new maintenance building to house our equipment and a place for our staff to work during inclement weather. This should save us on machine repairs as well as better utilization of our staff. Our landscape is constantly improving, and I especially like the year-round flowering plants along Lakeside Club. We have updated the pool area by purchasing new umbrellas, added more tables and chairs and chaise lounges. We updated our rules to allow, with restrictions, music as well as food and drink inside the pool area. We have finally settled our dispute with Comcast and have received our overcharged back payments so that we now, everyone that wants HD TV as well as HD equipment for your TVs will be installed free until January. So if you have not done this, if you have not converted to HD TV, I would suggest you do it because they're going to charge you $50 or something to put it in after the first of the year. Our budget committee has worked hard to arrive with a budget that is keeping our fees at a minimum. Our operating budget is less than last year, but as you've heard, because of the increases in products and labor, our reserves had to increase. Overall, we still pay less maintenance fee in 2017 than we did in 2015. We have added new signs that warn people of the possible dangers of snakes and alligators in our lake. And we're encouraging all residents not to feed any wild or feral animals, as they may carry diseases or may cause bodily harm. Last, I'm disappointed that we have not made more headways with the deplorable sight of the fence along Orange River Boulevard. We've gone to Lee County Commissioners meetings to state our case, met with one, emailed two, as well as having two meetings with the Lee County Department of Transportation. We feel they are asking too much of us to fix their problem. I know there's been a lot of controversy about the new changes that are proposed to be voted on during December the 7th special board meeting. I'd like to explain my interpretation of the rules and regulations. Some of you may agree and others may disagree, but this is how I interpret the rules. I think they're mostly for everyone's pleasure and should be followed as an honor system. This is honoring the wishes of most of our residents. These are set down to make our life here at Pine Ridge safer and more neighborly. We won't call the sheriff if you break the rules. These are not laws, but it means that you may make someone else feel unaccepted, uncomfortable, or unhappy. I have a few examples to make my point. Not cleaning up a dog mess may be easier for the owner, but stepping in a dog mess is not a pleasant experience for anyone, especially if you're wearing sandals or flip-flops. Therefore, we're asking all dog owners to please clean up after their pets. Leaving food scraps at the pool deck that may attract and make it may attract ants and make it unpleasant for others who come later just shows a lack of respect for those people that follow you, that you don't clean up after yourselves. Reserving a number of seats at the clubhouse or pool makes those that are not included feel like they do not belong. I understand that we want to be with our closest friends, but please don't exclude those who may someday become our friends. Instead, I would like to see all of us invite people to join our smaller groups rather than exclude them. Abusing the equipment at the bocce or shuffleboard court only makes it more confusing and bothersome for the next people that may want to use the facility. And taking glass onto the pool deck is potentially dangerous if it is accidentally broken. So we're asking that no glass of any kind be taken into the pool area. If you have a wine bottle, decant it into something plastic, bring it on down and have a good time. We have music at the pool, and interrupting this with others with singing and playing of instruments may be bothersome to others. Therefore, we have provided a place for singing and playing in the south picnic area, right down behind us. Amen. Enough preaching to the choir. Do you have any committee reports?
Well, if there's any good news, either Eric or Tommy will steal it with their report. So there's no further news from the landscape committee. Although I would like to invite people, because we will be having landscape committee meetings, and we'd like to invite anybody that's interested to show up. If you're curious about how decisions are made, an example would be the cocoa mulch we're going to try this year. That was actually decided in a committee. So, and that's how we like to do things here. Anybody, any residents, welcome to come to the committee. We hash things out. We come to a decision. We present it to either Eric or the board and find out if we can afford to do it, if it's legal to do it, what we ought to do it. And then we can. So, and I'd like to ask you, since we can't always get around everywhere, if you see a problem with any of the landscaping, just let somebody know. Let Eric know if you see me wandering around. Let anybody know, and we'll try to address it as soon as we can. Thank you.
We don't report until the 7th. Most of it was given out of room.
Any other committee?
No.
Okay, do we have any old business that should be returned to the board at this time? Okay, we'll move on to new business. Our first order of business, new business, is to affirm and approve the 2017 operating and reserve budgets.
I move that they be approved.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Okay, it's been a motion been made that we approve our 2017 budget as prepared by the budget committee. And it's been seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Pass. As in the past, after the election, there's such a short period of time, you know, the election is held and then the people take their seats at the table up front and then have an election of officers. So the community does not choose officers. The officers are chosen by the board members. So we all start out as directors and then we appoint a president, a vice president, treasurer, a secretary from that seven. So it's been in the practice in the past that we wait a month before we come to that conclusion of who's going to be who on the board. And so I'd like a motion to follow that tradition in making our choosing the board, executive officers of the board on the January meeting.
I move that the officers be approved, the executive officers be approved at the January meeting.
I have a second.
Second.
Motion been made and seconded that we elect our officers in January rather than December. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Pass. Any other business that we have to go for us tonight? Anybody's agenda? Okay, we now are going to take a few minutes for an open forum. If you want to speak at the open forum, raise your hand. I'll point to you, come up and make your point. And
are we having an open forum during the meetings?
Yes.
Okay.
We used to do this.
Mr. Apple?
I'm up there. We can probably hear you. And if not, we can repeat the question.
I just wondered if the board had considered a review. Since the audit is $10,000, you can get primarily the same thing for a whole lot less money. You just order a review rather than a complete audit.
I didn't know that, Don, but we'll discuss it. Thank you.
I don't know if you have any intention of replacing the rug. But I'd like to make a suggestion, perhaps between board money and maybe social club fundraiser money, we could change this to a wood floor and stop with the stains and having it washed and spot and allergy, because we have such a beautiful clubhouse and the rug looks terrible. So, thank you.
You don't like this thing?
Yes.
I have a question for the board. How do we get out if we're leaving between 9 and 6 a.m.? What's the code?
That's actually an excellent question. I should have mentioned that. It is now free access 24 hours a day. So when you pull up, you'll be able to exit without
Come
five different roofing companies last week, and there's actually a sixth that will also be bidding. And right now, they're going to be out here. You may see some people out on the roofs looking. We're going to take those bids. They're due on December the 2nd. And then our engineering firm will analyze them and present to us a spreadsheet back, kind of like first choice, second choice, third choice. And it's a number of factors. It's not just price that we look at. From there, the board will make their selection. And the schedule at this point is to begin in April of 2017 and end in September of 2017. We have 17 roofs that are due to be done next year. Then from there will be an ongoing process, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, every year, depending on where they line up. The roofs get replaced every 18 years, and the 25-year shingles.
How do you know which one who gets it?
We have a spreadsheet that was maintained that shows, so we know when each one was done and when,
at 18. In other words, I don't know. My roof was good, but I don't know.
I can let you know when yours is. If you guys are interested to know when yours is, come and see me one day, and I'd be happy to do that for you.
Thank you.
Pat?
Someone mentioned garbage earlier, and what I've noticed with my dumpster is when I open up the door of it, I can see right through the back because it's all rusted out at the bottom. So I think the garbage company should be told to come pick up the faulty dumpster and drop a new one.
We can absolutely do that. And if you see a problem like that where dumpster's rusted out or something, some other problem, come down, fill out a work order, and that way we have it in writing and we can address it. A lot of things get said in passing either to Brett or Bruce or George outside or to me. And I try to be good at remembering everything, but even I sometimes forget what to do. So please come in. If you have a problem like that, it's a perfect thing. Fill out a work order. And it's usually just a phone call or two to correct something like that. But if we don't know about it, then we don't make those calls. So please.
We were talking about cleaning up after the dogs. It would be nice if you see in some of these communities they have like a mesh basket on corners that is a dog station. You still have to put it in a plastic bag. But then that collects it. It's if you're walking around and the reason they don't pick up is because now they have to carry that bag.
We've discussed this several times, and you probably wasn't in on our last meeting some time ago. But we felt that this is a maintenance job that we just can't handle, and it's up to the responsibility of the owners to take care of their pets. And we don't have stations to dump their stuff. They have to find a dumpster. Anything else? Okay, Janet.
First, I want to thank you all for coming. It's nice to have all of you here. And now this meeting is adjourned.
I have to get a few more.
How you feel? You banged up a little bit, huh?
I was just helping.
They came in. He said, I have a discharge. He said, I was ready to go home. And I told him, I said, listen, I'm going to be sitting here. I got to get the keys there. I'm not getting out until I get up the keys there. So they kept me over. They were trying to push me out. We have private. I don't have many.
I got one more.
Phil, can you do one then? Because I'm not going to be here.
Yeah.
All right, thanks.
Where you going? I'll tell you.
Huh?
Where you going?
To the airport. Probably. All right. Scheffler's, Reagan's, my parents, Aunt Marie's, mine. Did I get them all? Scheffler's, Annie's, Brennan, Dravland, okay.
Take care. Yes, take care. You all right?
Now the meeting is 7.
Got a high charge.